Hello dear all, so today I discuss chapter from Kant's philosophy, Materialism in Medicine. So let's first understand what is the meaning of the title. So here medicine means not medicines or drugs, it is a therapeutic science. That is the meaning of the word medicine. And materialism. So materialism means what? The material aspect, that is physical aspect, that is tangible aspect of the disease in medicine, as well as physical, that is quantity present in the drugs for treating the diseases. So as we discuss further, we will understand what is the concept which is discussed by Dr. Kant in this chapter of Materialism in Medicine. So reference of aphorism number 30 is given. The human body appears to admit of much more powerfully affected in its health by medicines than by natural morbid stimuli. For natural diseases are cured and overcome by suitable medicines. So it means that the human's body receives treatment as of by the medicines, and this is more powerful to effect cure as compared to the natural diseases which also effect cure in nature. For example, smallpox removes ophthalmia, mumps removes orchitis. These examples are mentioned in the aphorisms. So here the comparison is done that it is always better that the medicines cure the patient than the natural disease which is stronger. Say for smallpox removes weaker disease, that is the ophthalmia, because the natural disease which is stronger then remains after it removes the weaker similar disease. So it is found in nature that smallpox removes ophthalmia, but then smallpox remains, which is more dangerous to the life of a patient. So medicines are superior than the natural disease curing agents. So medicine here means therapeutic branch of science, and medicines means they are well proved drugs, and remedies means the medicines which cure. So let's see what is the materialism in allopathy. Allopathy is a broad term which is used for modern medicine as well as for old school. So materialism in field of medicine. So it means nothing but physical presence of disease, that is the tangible products of disease. Tangible means which can be felt by fingers. So liver is enlarged, is felt by fingers. Warts are there, corns are there. So all these overgrowths, they are felt by fingers. They are palpable. So physical presence of the disease. So here they accept that the disease is visible. There is pathology in organs. Example, liver cirrhosis. Then the other diseases seen by eyes or measured by instruments, or they are in the quantity. So materialism in medicine with respect to the field of old school or modern medicine, or we call allopathy, is with respect to the concept of disease. So for them, disease is tangible, it is visible. So ulcer is present in the stomach mucosa, then this is a disease. So till that time when there is no visible products of disease, they don't deny the presence of disease. So the physical presence is must, and the quantity of the drug substance is also nothing but materialism in the field of medicine. In homeopathy, what is the materialism in field of homeopathy? So there is no materialistic field or materialistic concept in homeopathy. The concept in homeopathy is dynamic. So with respect to the disease, we consider disease is dynamic derangement of vital force. And with respect to drugs also, there is no quantity in the potentized medicines in homeopathy. So the dynamic concept of disease, it means that the disease develops due to derangement of vital force. For a homeopath, disease is intangible, disease is invisible. Now, what do you understand by these two terms? It means that the disease is nothing but, we already know, it is totality of symptoms. Now, what is the intangible disease and invisible disease? It is nothing but symptoms of mental generals and physical generals. So the causes of diseases are invisible. They begin in mind. They begin from center. So where is the center? Dr. Kent already discussed in the lecture or in the chapter of law and government from center. So center is considered in the brain, spinal cord, and it is originated in the mind. So brain, spinal cord, central nervous system are the physical presence of this center. So causes are beginning in center. Causes also begin in mind, in the thoughts. Now these thoughts again center and in the dynamic form. Disease on organ pathology, effects of causes are nothing but ultimates of disease. Disease is nothing but the ultimates of the cause. Means what? The causes are beginning in center and they have effect on organs. So homeopath perceives disease not by palpation and not by visible disease, so by his eyes, but he perceives disease by sense of mind. So the physician's sense of mind, he can perceive the disease. And how he can perceive this disease? It is by case taking. So by case taking, physician perceives the disease. Means he perceives the invisible and intangible disease. Now, what is invisible, intangible disease? Nothing but symptoms of mental generals and physical generals. So, disease originates in the center, and how homeopath can appreciate this disease? It is through senses, and through case taking, he will come to understand mental generals and physical generals of patient. So this is nothing but called as case taking is an art, because by his skills of case taking, physician finds out the invisible, intangible disease in patient. That is nothing but mental generals and physical generals. So homeopathic concept of materialism in medicine does not exist. It is totally a dynamic concept in the field of medicine. So materialism is still growing today. Perception of physician is seeing with the understanding, and it seems to be totally lost today. The materialist refuses to believe anything that does not conform to the laws of time and space. So materialistic view physician requires the physical presence of disease. So for him, the disease must be measured, weighed, and it should occupy space. Otherwise, it has no existence. For him, everything beyond this is the material mind. It is mysterious. So if the disease is in the dynamic form, the materialistic physician denies its existence. So they look in vain in the material world for the cause. So the materialistic physician searches the cause in the material world itself. So if the liver is diseased, he will search the cause in the liver itself. How a liver as an organ will have cause and effects together? Material entity cannot have causative power. No creative influence. Means what? The material organ, say liver, how it can have any power to create or cause pathology? Because it is a material organ, it doesn't have any power or to cause any pathology. The causes or simple substances are in natural state, in motion, and they have influence on the body. So simple substance is a name given by Dr. Kane for vital energy. So where are the causes of disease? They are in the vital energy. The natural state for simple substance is that of power. So vital energy, which gives life to the living organism, has this power. So energy has power. So we accept electrical energy, we accept gravitational energy, we accept magnetic energy. So why we cannot accept life energy? The natural state of matter is rest and quietude, and it has no power unless acted upon. So the matter, state of matter, is materialistic. It is physical, and the its properties are quietude, silence, and no power to move unless acted upon. For example, if you take a vehicle, it is made up of the, say, iron. Iron is a matter, it is material. When the vehicle moves, it does not move on itself. It moves because of the fuel in it. Similarly, the organ pathology cannot be caused by the organ itself. There are causes which act upon the organs. These causes are invisible. They are intangible. These causes begin in the center. And as I told you earlier, physician can perceive not see, but he can feel these symptoms of the causes as mental generals and physical generals. Like the dead man whose tissues are at rest, it has no action of its own. Simple substance dominates matter and animates it. Means what? Simple substance means life energy. It dominates the matter. Means what? It acts upon the matter. That is, it acts upon the body and animates it. Means imparts life to it. So we can compare materialism in medicine. See the last time, on left hand side it is about homeopathy and on right hand side it is about old school or modern medicine. So let's see. So first point, in homeopathy we see world of motion called as world of power. So power is in the life energy, and this is the cause which acts upon the organs. Here there is inertia for the world of motion. So old school doesn't accept anything called as world of motion. They just see and accept the matter. In homeopathy, it accepts the power. In homeopathy, we accept world of life energy. In old school, it is world of dead matter. In homeopathy, the cause of disease in the realm of thoughts. The old school says the cause of disease in the realm of matter, means in the organs itself. In homeopathy, we say that the causes of the diseases are in the thoughts. And here in the modern medicine, it considers the causes are in the organs itself. So the pathology is because of some cause and which is in the organ itself. But how can organ start dysfunctioning on itself? It needs some causes, otherwise it cannot be dysfunctioned. So homeopathy accepts causes are invisible and results are visible. That is what we say in modern medicine. So homeopathy accepts that causes are invisible and it has effect on the organs. So old school accept that the whatever organ pathology which is visible is the disease. The results we see in the material form are due to the causes in the simple substance. So simple substance, again I remind, it is a word for vital force. So we call it as vital energy. Why? Because vital force, so force is mass into acceleration, and vital force does not have any mass. So Dr. Hahnemann changed the name to vital energy. So causes are beginning in the vital energy. They are invisible. So they can be visible only to the spiritual eye of the physician. Means his senses. And what is the senses? He will be able to perceive the symptoms of mental generals and physical generals, where the causes of disease originate. The materialistic physician cannot grasp this idea. We have the grandest confirmation of these things in the wonderful action of our potencies in varying degrees. These are the degrees of simple substance. So our homeopathic remedies are having different potencies. Potencies means there is presence of the dynamic quality of the drug substance. So there are degrees. So potencies are compared with the degrees of simple substance. So degrees of vital energy. These are related to the different planes in the interior of economy. Means what? So if the patient is getting result with say silica 30 and his sinus is getting cured, but now the cure comes to halt, then the further cure is completed by silica 200. So this is degrees of the potencies, and these degrees in the higher and higher potencies connect with the different planes of the vital energy or simple substance of the individual. So interior of economy means what? It connects with the energy of patient. Every curable disease is made known by signs and symptoms. So homeopath considers totality of symptoms. Incurable disease have very few symptoms. Example, say if the disease is incurable, say patient having cancer of liver. So here patient will give lot of signs and very few symptoms. All curable diseases have signs and symptoms to show disorder of vital force or interior of man. So there is disorder of vital force and patient goes into the state of disease. These images of sickness are not seen by ignorant materialistic physician. So these changes or the images of sickness can be perceived by homeopath via his art of case taking, where he perceives patient's mental generals and physical generals. These symptoms represent invisible beginning of the disease. Dr. Hahnemann recognizes divine order. Divine order means what? The supreme energy. Supreme energy rules the universe. And we are a part of universe. So there is always a divine order. Divine means the godly. So there is in nature, everything goes by order and law. Materialistic do not recognize the laws, principle and government. So the laws exist in the plant kingdom, in animal kingdom as well, in the mineral kingdom. They do not change their properties. So the laws of nature are eternal, permanent. Dr. Hahnemann was not in the strict sense discovered the law, but Hippocrates had said disease might be cured by opposites or similars. He discovered these by pure experiments. He found corroboration of the principles. So Hippocrates had stated the law of similars, but he did not work further except Dr. Hahnemann. In the 18th century, he discovered the law of similars and worked extensively on this. Thus, homeopathy is a very important branch of therapeutic medical science. Everything that flows from center must have connection with that center. So, man in the healthy state is due to the result of normal activity of a unit. Unit means a unit of a man's health. So what is man's health? It is mental, physical, social, spiritual well-being, or it is also called as trinity of life, which is mind, body and soul. So everything functions as a unit in harmony. This harmony is seen in the state of health. So his healthy vital force is the result of action from center. When man becomes diseased, in his disordered state, he is still a unit and has to be considered collectively. His physiological actions do not produce the morbid actions, but the morbid actions so completely dominate him that he is one morbid state. So man goes into the morbid state. We also see the morbid state when he is dominated by action of drugs. We study man in three planes: the study of man in his natural state, the study of man in his sick state from natural disorder, or the study of man in his sick state from artificial disorder. Means what? The study of man in the state, natural state, that is in the state of health. So while taking the case, we ask the patient's disposition, his cravings, aversions before the his condition that he comes into the state of disease. Then we study the man in his sick state. So when during his sick state, what are his symptoms? Then the study of man in his sick state from artificial disorder. So we try to correlate the patient's symptoms with the symptoms of the materia medica, where the action of medicines upon provers and what symptoms they develop is noted. Thus, this amongst these medicines, similimum is selected, and this produces artificial similar disease in the patient, which removes the natural similar disease. Thus, materialism in homeopathy does not exist. It is the totally dynamic concept of disease, as well as the cure is effected by the administration of dynamic drugs. Study of each disease as a unit is done. So we consider the patient's disease with respect to symptoms of mind, body, mental generals, physical generals, and physical particulars. Physician studies all the symptoms observed in the chronic disease. He also studies the acute miasms, studies remedy reaction. He matches the images in the materia medica with the patient's totality. Individualization of patient is done on generals. So we generalize not by comparison of physical particular symptoms, but by mental generals and physical generals. Every person is different from other with respect to his mental makeup and physical generals. Thus, the appetite, cravings, aversions, thermal state, perspiration, stool, urine, all the symptoms are different of each individual from other. So homeopath does the study of particular symptoms as well, and he does the comparison of the materia medica and applies it by selection of similimum. So modern medicine or old school The concept of materialism is everywhere with respect to the concept of disease as well as treatment of it is by the large material hazardous doses which produce various side effects. So for modern medicine, disease is material presence of organ pathology. So disease must be visible, palpable. Pathology is seen under microscope, caused by organisms. So disease is caused by organisms, say bacteria, viruses, parasites or fungi. So disease is presence of faulty fluids, say discharge of effusion, ascites, ulcer. Disease is organ pathology, that is, say the tonsils are enlarged or presence of gangrene is a disease for a old school physician. The treatment is by local applications or by surgery of removal of pathology or by the large doses of the drugs. Disease is recognized by its name, that is nosological diagnosis. For a allopath or for a physician of old school or modern medicine, the organ pathology is important. Thus, in homeopathy, disease is dynamic derangement of vital energy. Disease is symptoms not only of visible organ pathology, but of invisible dynamic symptoms of mental generals and physical generals. And this is the cause of disease which originates in this interior of man, and these causes are reflected as the symptoms of mental generals and physical generals. The treatment is by similimum, by minute potentized doses. Disease originates in the invisible interior of living organism. And in homeopathy, the name of disease is not important for treatment. Thank you.